Hello guys, good afternoon. I Rajesh Kumar Maurya from Mechanical Engineering Department, GLBITM Greater Noida. Let us continue with fourth unit, that is reciprocating pump. We are going to discuss another topic, that is coefficient of discharge, volumetric efficiency and slip. Before understanding the coefficient of discharge, we should know what is the theoretical discharge and what is the actual discharge. Theoretical discharge of any reciprocating pump is defined as the ability to deliver the liquid per second, or you can say capacity to handle the volume of liquid per second. For single acting pump, what will be the theoretical discharge? We will derive here. All of you know, volume of liquid sucked by the pump is nothing but it is the area of piston. Area of piston, we can say cylinder, area of cylinder also if there is very less clearance, into stroke length. Stroke length is nothing but it is 2 times of the crank length. AL is the volume of liquid sucked by the pump. Now, theoretical discharge per unit revolution, per unit revolution, here N is the revolution, that is round per minute. In 1 minute, how number of round can do the piston? The A into L into N by 60 will give the theoretical discharge per revolution, that is unit is meter cube per second. If there are small n cylinders, then the theoretical discharge becomes A into L into capital N into small n over 60, where n is the number of cylinder. It may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And due to the space shortage, I have not given the notations of these letters. You should see, I am reading the notations. A is area of piston, L is the length of stroke, N is the RPM of the piston, crank, RPM of the crank. For double acting pump, what will be theoretical discharge in case of double acting? All of you know, in double acting, in both sides of the piston, the water is being in contact. It means the AP is the area of piston rod, which is right side of the piston, and it covers the area of piston. Piston rod covers the area of piston. So, we have to subtract this area from the piston area, then we will get actual area of the piston on the crank side. That is why we have written here, the cross-sectional area of piston on crank side will be A minus A suffix P. A is the area of piston and AP is the area of piston rod. If we subtract, we will get actual area of piston on the left side. Now, theoretical discharge becomes, because it is double acting, then discharge on both sides, in left side of the piston and right hand side of the piston. That is why the total theoretical discharge will be ALN by 60 plus A minus AP into LN by 60. If area of piston rod is very very less than area of piston, then it can be neglected. Then it can be neglected. If it is neglected, it becomes 2 times of the ALN by 60. If it is neglected, then it becomes 2ALN by 60. You can see clearly, if there is double acting pump, then discharge will be just twice of that of the single acting pump. Now, we will see what is the coefficient of discharge. Yes, coefficient of discharge is denoted by C suffix D. It is nothing but it is the ratio of actual discharge minus actual discharge over theoretical discharge. Actual discharge means what? Actual discharge is always less than the theoretical discharge, because in actual discharge we are assuming that there is some leakage through valve and pipes, right? The actual discharge is always lesser than the theoretical discharge, and this ratio is known as the coefficient of discharge. What is the volumetric efficiency? If the coefficient of discharge is written in terms of percentage, then it is known as volumetric efficiency. A volumetric efficiency in a case of reciprocating pump is defined as the percentage ratio of actual over theoretical into 100. This is known as the volumetric efficiency of the reciprocating pump. Then one term is come in reciprocating pump, slip. This slip is totally different from the pulley and belt. This slip is nothing but it is the difference between theoretical discharge minus actual discharge. Always theoretical discharge is greater than actual discharge. It means the value of slip is positive. Then this is known as the positive slip. There is another terms, negative slip also. Negative slip also means what? If theoretical discharge is less than actual discharge, then it is known as the negative slip. And what is the percentage of slip? Percentage of slip is nothing but it is the difference between theoretical discharge minus actual discharge over theoretical discharge into 100 give the percentage of slip. This is used in numerical. These formula are used for calculating the theoretical negative slip and positive slip. There is one condition for the negative slip. When the negative slip occurs, if the suction pipe length is very long as compared to the delivery pipe in reciprocating pump and it is rotating at very high speed, then this situation comes that before completing the suction stroke, the delivery valves open and extra amount of water is already delivered into the delivery pipe. That is why in that time the actual discharge become more as compared to the theoretical discharge. Due to that reason, the negative slip will occur. Means there will be actual discharge will be more as compared to the theoretical discharge. Now, what is the work and power input and efficiency? Work input, we have to calculate here one work input. All of you know, and we have discussed earlier in working principle of the reciprocating pump. H is the suction head and SD is the delivery head. And total head becomes what? Suction head plus delivery head makes a total head, that is H. It's equal to HS plus HD. W is here specific weight and Q is here discharge, all having the SI unit. I have not written here SI unit, but you have to write. Then what is the power input? Power input, this is the theoretical power input, is W, that is specific weight, into Q into H. Here W is here rho g into Q into H, unit is in watt. Also written, it can be also written in place of Q. Already we have discussed in previous, that is Q is nothing but it is ALN by 60 for the single reciprocating pump, single stroke. In that case, it will be written as rho g in place of Q ALN by 60 and in place of H, that is total H, HS plus HD. For double acting theoretical pump, it becomes what? Rho g AL 2N by 60 into HD plus HS. This is theoretical power. My theoretical power should be always less than the actual power. Actual power means what? The power which is required to run the reciprocating pump is known as the actual power. Means we can say the power which is required or we are going to supply for running the pump. So what will be the efficiency? If we are going to calculate the efficiency, it is the ratio of theoretical power, that is P suffix T, over actual power into 100 will give the efficiency of reciprocating pump. This is all about the reciprocating pump, and with the help of these formulas we will see in next lecture some numerical based on that. Thank you very much.